A lot can happen in 20 years. I'm thinking Back to the Future 2, anyone? Hoverboards, aren't we still waiting for that? Teleportation, perhaps? But what about turning on the news to hear the words, we are not alone in our galaxy? Because it turns out the folks at NASA are so confident, they say the proof of alien life could come within our lifetime. So this panel of these super smart science space experts holding a meeting in Washington to discuss exactly how NASA expects to find the first inhabited planet. So joining me now is Charles Bolden. He is a NASA administrator. He has commanded multiple crews on multiple space shuttles, graduate of the U.S. Naval Academy. Charlie Bolden, am I right in all these accolades for you? Welcome back to the show, by the way.
It's good to be here, Brooke. Thank you very much.
So with all the accolades and everything you are, you've accomplished, you have said that you have, every time you've gone up to space, and I was just asking you in the commercial break, you said that you actually were looking for life up there. Seriously?
You're always looking to find out if, you know, the ultimate question is, are we alone? And that's
right.
What NASA is about. You know, President Obama has challenged us to put humans on Mars in the next 20 to 30 years, in the 2030s. And that's our focus right now. That's the focus of the agency. So
can we be clear?
Robotic missions.
Can we be clear, though? Can we define life? I mean, we're not, we joke about it a little bit tongue in cheek here, but we're not talking little green men. I mean, are we talking moss? What are we talking about?
You are talking about anything that is organic, anything that is a building block of life as we know it. And I tell people all the time, we may find that they're microbial forms of life. There may be much more advanced forms of life than we don't know. We just want to find out. We believe that in this vast universe, there are other forms of life other than just here on this planet.
It's hard to think that we would possibly be alone, but I'll leave it to you and the folks at NASA to figure this out. Which, speaking of, how will you find this out? Can you just talk me through logistics of finding life?
Yes. In fact, we've been searching for life for many, many years. We have two rovers right now on Mars. One is Curiosity, and an older one is Opportunity. Curiosity is specifically it's got little chemistry labs on board. It's constantly taking samples from the soil, samples from rock. We are trying to get humans to the planet because we know that whenever humans go, they can do things much quicker over much vaster expanses than the robots can.
Can I just ask you, what's the thought among you and you astronaut types as far as what really lurks out there? What's the thought? What do you all talk about up there?
I'm not sure anybody has a guess as to what's out there. I think most of us believe that there is life form of some type, whether you're talking about, the planet Enceladus, the moon Enceladus, or the moon Europa of Jupiter, where there's a lot of interest now, other solar systems. I believe that a multi-planet species is the kind of species that will survive in perpetuity. And we just want to demonstrate the fact that there is other life other places.